Good morning, guys. Well, I got an interesting one for you here. This is going to be one that I'm going to take you along for the diagnosis. I just turned the lights on, and the first thing I noticed when I hooked up my trailer is that my marker lights aren't on, even though the lights are on. Let's come around to the back and have a look at the rear lights. And you can see the rear lights are on. Now let's try a signal light. I've got the left signal light on. And on the truck, the left signal is blowing brightly on just the one side. But look at this, this one's firing off. But look at this. Do you see that? Even though I don't have the right signal on, I've got the left signal on, the right one is flashing. That should send a bell off in your head. What would cause the right signal light to flash when you've turned the left one on? Why don't you think about that for a second? We'll try it the opposite way. Got the right signal on. Right signal's flashing, left is steady. Look at this. Left is flashing when the right is on. Do you see that? What's the diagnosis? Okay, I'm going to use my power probe for this, and I'm just going to see if we got a ground here. And I think most of you would agree that the multimeter here, built-in multimeter, shows as a ground. But remember, we don't have electrons moving. So we got to turn something on. Let's turn on the signal light. Okay, now I've got electrons flowing with the left signal light. And we're getting a lot of trouble. How can we make that a little clearer? Well, let's use a test light. I'm just going to test the ground here on the chassis to ground on the battery. And what do you see? What's the diagnosis? Okay, the left signal light is flashing and the test light is providing a short circuit to ground. But remember, the test light has a certain amount of resistance as well, and so things won't necessarily go back to normal with the test light in line. Let's get rid of the test light and just hot wire our ground directly through the ground wire of the power probe. Now, you don't need to have a power probe to do this. You could just use a ground wire, but let's go to the back and just see if it works normally. And now, this light is flashing brightly. The other one's not flashing at all. So that's solved that problem. Let's see if the marker lights work. Turn our lights on. And indeed, marker lights are on. So we verified a bad ground. The problem is, we don't know where it is. How are we going to sort that out? Okay, now here's the ground connection right here on the trailer. Could our bad connection be right there? Well, let's have a look. I've got the signal light is flashing. I've got the test light here hooked up to ground at the battery. And we've still got the light. So we know at least the outside of that, the wire itself, let's do it this way, is still on the bad side. So we know it's somewhere between here and the battery. How are we going to sort out where that is? Okay, now we've proven that the at least the screw attachment point for the ground at the trailer is good. I could pierce this wire, it's going to be the white wire. I could pierce that to see if we get the same thing here, but I think that's unnecessary and it's a bit destructive. Now our problem could be in the connection here at this connector. It could be on the trailer side or on the car side. And so I'm going to disconnect and take off some of this tape. We'll see if we can do it in a little less destructive manner by back probing. So I stripped the tape away and I see a bare spot here that's going to be the ground. So let's see if this flashes this way here. And indeed it does. And so what I've proven here is that this little wire section between the ground screw and the plug is fine. And our problem is on this side of that connector. What are we going to do next? Let's do a voltage drop test on the same thing. With electrons flowing, I've got that signal flasher going. You can see that we get a ground and we lose a ground. So we've got a significant voltage drop on this side. So let's open this up and see if there's any corrosion on the spade connectors themselves. And I'm not seeing anything here. For those unfamiliar with the LoadPro, here's a diagram of what I'm going to do next. Here's the battery, here's the truck side of the connector, and we want to evaluate the ground pathway between the two. The goal is to estimate how much total resistance there is in that ground wire, and I'm going to do that by inserting a fixed known resistance in series and then get electrons moving and measure the drop across my known resistance. The LoadPro is simple. It has a switch, a 10 amp circuit breaker, and a 25 ohm resistor. You could easily make that yourself. I'm going to do two measurements of voltage drop across that 25 ohm resistor, first with switch open and then with it closed. If the two numbers are almost the same, we know total unknown resistance along that wire is very low. You can do this kind of testing in any wire, but I should mention that if you're going to use this method to evaluate an abnormal ground wire, there is a small risk that other devices attached to the same ground upstream of the severe resistance might be backfed with battery power. In this case, the risk is vanishingly small, but if you're worried about that, you could disconnect other devices before doing this.
Now for this next bit, I've unhooked the connector, and I'd like to do testing on it, and so I've hooked up an alligator clip to the ground lead on this side to see if the problem of high resistance is on this side of the connector or on the side I just connected. And indeed, we've got a ground here, but that shouldn't be completely reassuring because that's what we showed before. And so I'd like to do further dynamic testing. And so the way I'm going to do that is with a LoadPro. You don't have to use the LoadPro, but it does offer the option of doing it more quickly. So this basically short circuits the 25 ohm resistor, and we watch that voltage. It's 11.99 and it drops to only 11.34, and so what that tells me is that there is very little resistance from this side into the truck, and so our resistance is in that connector itself. The resistance is right in here. That's our problem, or at least in the connection between the two. So now I'm going to take some deoxic spray and spray in here and hope that I can refresh these connections enough that I get a good ground. Okay, here's what I'm using today. There are only four wires that go into this. This is the ground, that's the positive, this is one signal light, and that's the other signal light. 0.1 ohms. Now, of course, this isn't dynamic testing. It's not under any significant current. Okay, so last night it was getting dark, it was starting to rain. I laid down in the mud, I made my diagnosis, and went into the house. And so now I'm going to retrace my steps for this morning. The first thing I did was to put the connector back into the truck, and it still didn't work. We've proven the truck side is okay, and we've shown the trailer side is okay too. So the only possible diagnosis left is high resistance right where the spade connectors meet up. Here's the truck side of the connector. It looks clean. Then I reached in with my pocket screwdriver, and I pried the ground post out a little, thinking that the post might be slightly bent and we just weren't making good contact. Then I put it back together again and voila, problem is solved. Well, I hope you followed along. This stuff isn't that difficult. With a little bit of thoughtful testing, getting to a diagnosis is usually easy. You don't usually have to guess. Thanks for watching.